Dave, you touched on the defensive side. We didn't have a chance to track you down after the decision was made to retain Todd Grantham. Your thoughts?
I thought it was time to move on, Mark. I was a Grantham defender for longer than most. There were some in the fan base, and I'll give them a little bit of credit here, that saw the warts. Not like anybody saw this historic bad defense that Florida was going to put out there. Nobody saw that coming. But you know, Florida's been a top 10, top 15, top 20 defense under Todd Grantham the last couple of years. But in the big games, and I did point this out, this was an area improvement that Florida needed to get better in on defense. In the big games, the defense has to show up. And then and you go back to 2019, defense plays better. You beat Georgia. Defense gets one or two stops versus LSU. That's more of a game late in the fourth quarter instead of LSU kind of basically being able to salt the game away there. You know, and you couldn't get to the quarterback. You couldn't get to Jake Fromm and Joe Burrow in 2019. Those things had to get better. Didn't get better, and Florida got worse on defense. And I could – you know, COVID was it some sort of excuse? It was, but it wasn't the full excuse of why you couldn't get lined up in the first game of the season versus Ole Miss with all the experience that you had on defense, all the experience that came back, and you still couldn't get lined up versus Oklahoma in the bowl game. You played 12 games. You've been playing football for 3.5 months, and you know, then the tackling was an issue all season long. The physicality there, you know, so mentally, physically, the defense was just seemed it was hardly ever ready to go. Even in games where Florida, a lot of people faulted us for nitpicking. Oh, well, Florida's still winning games, but there was that stretch right after Georgia and Arkansas where Florida played Kentucky, they played Vanderbilt, they played Tennessee. You could see this, you know, the defense, okay, yeah, they were keeping teams to only scoring 10, 13, 17 points, but you could see, okay, well, these teams, Florida was getting beat deep a whole lot. Quarterbacks couldn't connect on it. I mean, we saw it in the Georgia game a whole lot. You know, Georgia had their opportunities, just couldn't connect on it. You could see at the time we were calling it nitpicking. But in the end, it was like, no, these are things better teams are going to go do against Florida. And you saw it versus Alabama. LSU was able to do it. And it was, you know, teams with young quarterbacks. Vanderbilt's true freshman quarterback threw for over 300 yards. Max Johnson in his first start versus LSU comes into the swamp and beats Florida because the defense couldn't get a true freshman quarterback off the field. So, Mark, I think as each issue just compounded week after week after week, that's when I can no longer defend Todd Grantham. And I think it was time for Florida to move on, but it looks like he'll be around for another year.
Love the Florida football talk with David Waters from Gators Breakdown. So I would invite you and encourage you to head on over to Gators Breakdown. You can do that on YouTube, or you can check out the audio platform of your choice. Just look up Gators Breakdown, and there's at least one episode per week and multiple on certain weeks there with David and the rest of the crew.